Alright, hello everyone, welcome back to Azure Dreams. Just kind of doing an in-between episode or two before we head off to Mega Man Legends. First and foremost, a couple things I gotta mention in about 3 months that have passed since the last episode. I started a new file, essentially because of the fact that I want to make this a master file, and so I should probably mention a few things about my hut first and foremost. I did manage to get that Paloompa egg in the first run of the tower, which I unfortunately sacrificed in my last file. I also got the Dreamin egg, so I don't have my old U-boat egg that I used to have. However, I'm hoping to get some of those later, because those are really good eggs to have to teach some of my monster's spells. Should also just kind of show off what's in the safe. Yeah, absolutely nothing. Gold sword, I don't have mirror shield +3 like I did in the other file, but I do have 2 charges on my acid drain bottle, so a few minor differences. Should also just show this off that I actually do have my old save file backed up just in case, and I'm using this file instead. There's a couple reasons why I wanted to start a new file. First and foremost, this Let's Play save file is going to be something of a master file, so I'm going to try and do everything I possibly can in the save file. Even maybe once this Let's Play is over, I might still play this every now and then on my own personal time. Just to kind of get all the monsters and collect everything, just because I want to have a kind of a perfectionist file. So, another reason, if you kind of saw what I was talking about at the end of the last episode, these guys were treating me like I hadn't even been to the tower the first time. Well, that's because I never even talked to these guys before in the last time around. So, I've done about the same number of runs, and I really consider myself lucky when I was actually recording the last couple, the first 4 episodes of this Let's Play, because of the fact that I got a ton of money in those first several runs, and I did in the first run I did in 2 tries, and I got all that money and enough to upgrade my head. I wasn't even able to do that last time around in this save file. So I'm going to have to upgrade my hut. In just a moment here, and I do have enough money. It'll be 6,000. First and foremost, however, I want to talk to this guy, because I've been talking to this guy every time I've come back from the tower, and I've actually checked this guy out ahead of time just to make sure if he's going to suggest this or not. And yes, he is. He says, "By the way, are you interested in entertainment, Geico?" I say no to Fenderman. I don't know what that is. I am the entertainment. Geico, baby, let's get along. To come in right, our friendship, I'll tell you something very juicy. Theater. Geico, listen, the future is the age of culture. This town, Monsvaya, is going to be famous for its theater. You say you're going to make money in the tower. How about being a theater? You're hiring me. Fun, the entertainer. You sold out shows every night. Theater news, don't forget it. So he's suggested a new building for us to make, and we'll build that later. I'm going to save my money for the time being. Just kind of like the racing track, which I'm pretty sure I mentioned in one of the episodes. I don't remember everything I did 3 months ago, but another building that we can get suggested to build it here for the town is a library, and get that by talking to this guy about every time we come back from the tower. Before I know it, my books have taken over my home. Only since City had a library, I would then have a place to donate all these books. This way I would be able to find the books I wanted and would enhance the education level of the people. Don't you think it's a great idea? Oh, today the record of the Istaria War hits the bookstore, and I've got to get a copy. Okay, so he's also suggested the library, so that's 2 new buildings that we can erect sooner or later. Let's see here. Selfie, you got anything to say? Hi, Puffy Lips, it's Geico. You're jealous of my brother Gosh, and you're harassing him, aren't you? Enough is enough. Is that right? Yeah, you always kind of want to say, you always kind of want to take whatever answer is agreeing with her, or is closest to agreeing with her, and that'll eventually lead to, well, her falling in love with you. Can't you take responsibility yourself?
I pay you.
I don't know if that was the right choice, but, eventually, she'll like us more. With Nico and the fountain, I haven't actually donated the last 1,000 gold, just simply because I want to show one more, special portrait, I suppose. If you talk to Nico's dad, after you made a donation and before you've actually finished donating all the money you need to donate for the fountain, if you come in here and talk to Nico, you should have a little sparkly-eyed counting the coin portrait. And I actually do like Nico. She's one of my favorite characters in this game. Let's see. Total today is 1, 2, 3, hee hee. 999 gold to go for. Hee hee hee. So, you can actually figure out how much you need for the rest of the fountain. So, 1,000 from me and 1,000 plus 1 from Ghosh means that you only need 3,000. So, I'm going to say good luck. And, hey, thanks. We feel to make contributions any time. I'm going to do just that, actually. Even if we're going to overshoot that mark quite a bit here by donating 1,000, and Ghosh comes in and donates another 1,000, I'm still going to just go straight to 1,000. Thank you, Kako! So yeah, I just kind of wanted to show that little extra portrait that I missed in the last episode or two. Well, I should have shown that in the last episode. Nico Southie, here I am. I'm Gush Road. I'm going to help you. By the way, did this domain make a donation with Fountain? I need 1,000 gold. Well, I should have made 1,000 plus 1 gold. I've kind of seen this before. Excuse me. So, it'll be built by the next time we come back from the tower. Gush seems to be so cultured. That confused guy? I think he's... That confused guy? Barbarian, like, okay, I don't understand it. Well, probably a tomboy wouldn't like you understand it either. Anyways. let's see here. I should mention that you should keep talking to Pen here. Eventually, Pen will eventually suggest a building for you to make as well. I don't know if talking to him twice here would do it. The other day, I was fine giving him work, but I was turning. What do you say? Luck is starting to roll my way. Just keep talking to that guy, maybe twice, once you keep coming back from the tower. Eventually he'll also suggest another building. Now, we're going to expand the monster hut. Got 6,000 gold, so I have that. And, yes, just kind of saying before, those first few runs when I was actually recording were actually very, very lucky because I wasn't able to get hardly any money the first run or two in this specific file. And I was actually specifically going for a golden mirror shield again just to... And I made like, what, 30, 40 some runs. And I had to probably do that tutorial about 20 some times just to get it correctly. Not digressing, let's talk to Patty and just kind of get something else. Don't sit close to me, this wonderful taste of cranberry presents. Shut up! If you say don't sit too close to me too, you'll get out of your chair and, well, you won't eat anything. What are you telling me? Shut up. You're not me. Your mom watched out or shut up. Don't have to show up. I ain't ordering anything too expensive. Just have what you're doing, okay? Forget all that I ordered in this specific file. I am just going to order... We have to order everything eventually, so I'm going to just go for the very, very stingy route of rice. So now we're ordering the least expensive thing in the menu, and we get even more funny dialogue between us and Ghosh. Here you are! Yes, it's rice. That's it. That's all it says about it. Can humans eat that? I could say it's good, you want some, but this is even funnier if you say, hey, listen to this guy. I know I'm not playing anything against the restaurant food. Would you please leave? Darn, Gecko, I'll get you back for this. So we boot him out of here. Bill comes to 20 gold, I'm paying. Okay, so I'm always going to make sure you do that. I don't think I've ever shown the fortune teller's place, so I'm going to head over there real quick. And I also got something a bit to mend from the last video, is when I was cutting the video at the very end of the last episode, Wreath Arman was telling us something about a guy over by the windmills, so let's go talk to him in just a minute. This is kind of goes along with something that was supposed to happen in the game, but never actually did. Or maybe never got, maybe it got removed from the English or American version, I'm not sure. But if you remember when I said about how the girls could fall in love with you and all that, it's potential to get married. Sheila here, the fortune teller, will kind of give you a questionnaire and to see who you're most compatible with. However, there's really nothing to do here because of the fact that, well, there's no dating beyond dating. Relationships with the girls does not go beyond just, as far as general courtship and all that. So, don't kid around me. I'm giving a special way of giving a prize of a special pendant that makes a person love come true just by wearing it to a lucky winner. That's probably a hint to the fact that you probably could have gotten married at some point, but I've never seen a special pendant given to her, and I've kind of done... long time ago, I kind of went through all the answers, and you can talk to her as many times as you like and just keep going through all the questions and just kind of get your results of who she'd say you're most compatible with all the girls and all that, but... In the end, I don't think you get anything from there, so I'm pretty much going to be ignoring that place for the rest of the Let's Play. Yeah, it's Kaiko, Pulse and Fry, what brings you here? I'm going to buy. I'm not going to buy anything, so... like I said before, you don't actually have to buy anything from her, you just have to keep talking to her a lot. Then go home, this discussion costs me 1 gold in a minute. So, we've seen that before plenty of times. Since you've moved to tower, do you think you've changed? I'm still the same old me. I'm rich! That's right. You haven't changed, but every time I see you, you seem a little different. It's strange. Something I never brought attention to before is... People will actually say something if you talk to them from high areas. So, oh no, I can hear voices from, there must be some fools up there! Yeah, there are some of those people in town will actually say things if you're talking to them when you jumped on top of something. Let's go check out the windmills that our mom told us to talk about, to check out. I never actually brought it up at the end of the last episode because, well, it was coming up on screen when I went to go save it at the end of the last episode. I was like, let's see here. Got to talk to the guy over there first, but I'm going to talk to his assistant. I got training in the West because I wanted to start an octopus ball restaurant. When I came back, I could not get flour. I thought it was strange and I came here. Just listen to the Isaac's guy story, will you? And the guy your mom told us to talk to is Isaac. Oh my god, I broke the old girl's oil pot. The windmill won't work without it. This windmill used to grind wheat for 100 years. This windmill has been so useful to the townspeople. All of a sudden, its swing stopped. All we need to do is pour some girl's oil on the axle, but I broke girl's oil pot. The magic pot produces girl's oil from its own. You can't make girl's oil without girl's oil pot. So it's kind of like an infinite amount of oil that comes from this oil pot, or maybe you can only get a certain kind of oil by grinding things together inside the pot. But anyways, these windmills will not work. That goose oil pot, and that thing is actually found on the 15th floor of the tower, as he just told us. So we're gonna try and get that this episode if we can. So he asks us to go get the oil pot, and we'll try and get that. Also, one difference between this save file and the previous one is I think I only got up to the 13th floor when I was doing my recording last time, and I got to the 14th floor in this file. And yeah, next to our house, I'll actually tell us the highest level we've actually made it to in the tower. So she just said we gave it to the 14th floor. Suppose a couple more things to do around town. I'm just gonna keep checking in with Barry here. Just say keep looking around. Talk to him again and again after you, a second time after you've done your you're done with your shopping. And eventually he'll also suggest a new building for the town. And he's not doing that yet. Might as well head into the monster shop. I actually saw this guy off-screen, and all the monsters, there's one that changes its appearance when it goes up. I wish my own Takafu would change its appearance. That is actually a monster in the game. However, you'll never actually see it in the tower because, well, we'll get to that later. I should also mention that if I were to talk to the guy in the clinic, he would ask for 4,000 gold, kind of like Silver, who's asking for 3,000 gold to build a horse racetrack. The guy in the clinic will ask for 4,000, and that will turn the clinic into a hospital. So I could do that now, but again, I don't have the money for that, so I've only got 2,000 rather than 4,000. Anyways, I'm going to make a quick save here before we open the tower, and I'm going to actually start doing some blogging this time around. Yay! The whole purpose of this blog play, as I've mentioned before, is actually coming to fruition! Okay, so I've already got my pita fruit, by the way. lame joke. Anyways, heading back to the tower, and I'm actually not going to cut out the first floor. I'm actually going to keep going and talking about something I want to talk about. First and foremost, there is another goal item that I want to get while I'm in the tower, and that is a poison magic ball. I actually learned something on the forums, the GameFAQs forums, by the way, between this episode and the last one that I didn't even know about. And I'm hoping to get an item known as a poison ball. Kind of like my Esrine magic ball, there's one that casts poison spell. And apparently, if you put 10 charges on a magic ball, Acid Rain Ball does not actually count. You cannot actually do it with Acid Rain Balls, you can do it pretty much any other magic ball. But if you put 10 charges on a magic ball, you can actually give it to your familiar and they can learn the spell. So the reason why I want a poison magic ball, first and foremost, is because I want to teach Fenrir here, I want to teach him poison. And why would I want to teach him poison? Well, because of the fact that it actually has a special mixture magic. If this poison spell is different from any other fire spell. And there's 5 spells per magic category, but the poison spell is actually special for your familiars. And let's see here. Level 2, yay. Poison is the only one that's really different from all the other fire spells, because all the fire spells are pretty much just a straight line damage spell, and poison is different because of the fact that not only is the mixture magic different, but it actually, well, not only does it, I kind of ruined that there, not only does it have a different spell other than offensive magic, but the poison spell has different mixture magic. So typically when you mix am I gonna get that lucky again in the recording? But the thing about mixture magic and the fire spells, it says that all but the poison spell will simply mix into flame sword. So if I were to pull out getting hit by traps like a let's see here. Cheap crap. All fire spells except for poison will have the flame sword ability when you use mixture magic. And poison has a different one. It's actually a spell called Heat Wave, if I remember right. And there's only one monster in the game which naturally gets the poison spell, and you have to fuse it with another monster. But poison spell is probably the rarest of all the fire spells. But apparently, using that trick where you put these white sands on magic ball and pump it up to 10 charges. If you give that to your familiar, they'll learn the spell, and that's how I'm going to teach Fenrir his poison spell, rather than go through a very painstaking process of getting that one rare monster. And it's actually that rare monster I've been hinting at that exists on the 16th floor. Instead of getting that one rare monster, either getting really lucky and finding his egg somewhere, or using another method to get his egg, I'm actually going to try and get a poison ball, increase it to 10 charges, and give it to Fenrir and teach him poison spell that way. And never really explained what the difference between flame sword and blast wave is. Flame sword, your familiar will cast fire in your sword, and it'll be pretty much just a stronger attack that is also fire elemental. Blast wave, instead, is actually a line spell. So Geico himself could use could attack from range using your mixture magic, and that's the reason why I want to teach Fenrir the poison spell, is so I can have that at mixture magic. And just about done with the first floor, and the rooms are starting to collapse. And I think we'll get Selfie on the second floor, if I'm remembering right. I have not actually done any recordings ahead of time, so this is kind of like, I don't know what's going to happen on the second floor this time around. Yep, it's Selfie. So, hi there, Puppy Lips, how are things with you? You seem so busy, you're trying to get like me, that, no, we're family. So she just runs away. Eventually she'll start asking you questions here in the tower, and you just want to keep talking to her, both here and at the town. That's how you'll eventually, not going to spoil it too much right now, but eventually she'll fall in love with you. Just keep that in your line. That's all you really need to do. Anyways, log time, I suppose. I just kind of got something to say about... first of all, there's a reason why I created Azure Dreams, this Let's Play, right now, as opposed to... Well, my intention was to do blog plays with this once I get a good number of subscribers to my channel. However, there's a reason why I started this up much, much earlier than expected. And that's because of the fact that I really dislike Google Plus. And I'm probably just yet another chip in the pile with all the other people who don't like Google Plus. And it's probably just redundant. And probably just really late to the party just talking about this, but Google Plus irritates me, just to say the least. And I really don't like how they're interfering, I suppose, with how YouTube works. And I know you could probably just go on YouTube or Google and search how many people, search all sorts of videos where people are just angry with Google and how Google Plus just kind of ruined YouTube and all that. And Google, I suppose, just did not do anything good for YouTube. And I really don't hope I don't get in trouble with like my channel just talking about this thing. But it's kind of like, well, because I am talking about it on their own site. But I know I got freedom of speech. I got the right to say. Express my opinion, I suppose, but yeah, I do not like Google Plus. I don't like what they did to YouTube, especially with the comment system. And I know it's old news at this point, but oh, this can be bad. Hopefully it won't. Mirror Shield, please save me. I'm actually taking very little damage. Yeah, as I was saying with Google Plus, and I really hate how Google Plus ruined the YouTube's comment system, and it really hasn't gotten better, even with the update that just went down not long ago, I think in the last week. And I suppose, as good as time as any, I actually like the update. The update that they just did, I think, actually improved a few things. It could still work. It should still do a few things to improve the site, but I think overall the last update that went down probably could have did fix a few things. I actually like a few things about it, but again, a few things they don't like such as the column on the left side of the page is now a big drop down box that's part of, you know, your user toolbar on the very top of the page. And that thing I do not like. I wish that they would have just kept like menus on the left side screen the way they used to be. I really, really wish they'd go back to the old comment system still. That's my main gripe with Google Plus. You should have it sorted once again, automatically have it sorted by newest post first, because, you know, relevance is just sorting by relevance or most upvotes just really doesn't work for a site like YouTube. And I'm probably the millionth person to say this, but yeah, just that does not work at all, because of the fact that, you know, even if they tweak it and adjust the formula and all that, like they said they would, it's still not going to work all that great, because of the fact that the first couple comments will be the ones that are pretty much always going to be on top because of how they're the first ones seen, they're the first ones that get upvoted, and it's kind of like they'll shove all new comments down towards the bottom, and they'll probably not get seen. Another thing I don't like about Google Plus interfering with YouTube and all that in the comment system is how you're forced to have Google Plus in order to make comments. And I really dislike how they did that with YouTube because of the fact that if you have a YouTube account, you should be able to make comments. That's just, without really getting into any in-depth explanation, that's just something that should be a part of the site. You shouldn't be required to have Google Plus in order to do that. Another thing about using your real name with Google Plus is how you're forced to use either your real name or use two made-up names. And for a site like Google, that's kind of surprising because of the fact that they just kind of ruin I've always had trouble pronouncing that word. They've always kind of been an advocate for, against things like SOPA and net neutrality and being able to remain anonymous on the internet, but with the fact that they want you to use your real name with Google Plus and all their services, particularly YouTube and all that, which, well, I'm making a video for YouTube, one of the reasons I liked my Google emails is because of the fact that they kept me anonymous. And being anonymous on the internet is a very important thing because of the fact who knows who's out there lurking on the internet. And that's one of the main things about staying anonymous, the fact that because of all this, I have actually not actually signed up for a Google Plus account. So my YouTube account and my Gmail accounts, I have not actually set them up to use Google Plus, and for that reason I'm not able to make Google comments on YouTube, either for my friends' videos or my own videos, which is kind of strange because I can actually moderate comments and such on my own videos, but I cannot actually make replies, which seems kind of screwed up to me. And, well, yeah. I don't really have to say about that, but yeah. But yeah, with Google removing the ability to remain anonymous on sites like YouTube, I may just, they actually said that it's okay. They're not actually forcing you to use your real name, and I may do it just for my own channel, you know, separate it into Master and Fenrir as two names, but really, I shouldn't be required to do that at all, because like I said, it's kind of screwed up how I can control comments and moderate my own channel and all that, but I can't even write it on my own discussion page, or reply to replies on my own videos, so it's kind of like, Google, just get your act together and put it back the way it was. Nobody liked it to begin with, and nobody asked for it. It's like, Google, fix the site, please. You took a bit of a step or two with the last update you did, because, well, I did say I liked a few things with the most recent update. I think they actually fixed things with the playlists, because it's actually auto-saving. Probably not the best thing to have auto-saving when you're editing a playlist. But there were some issues I had with speed. Particularly, I have a pretty good computer and a fast internet connection, but I'm also using an older browser. I actually have not yet moved on from XP, Windows XP that is, and I'm actually primarily using Internet Explorer 8 because that's the most compatible version of Internet Explorer for Windows XP. And for a while I actually had to use Firefox for the sake of uploading videos because, well, they did not want to be compatible with Internet Explorer 8, despite, like, what, 25% of the internet users using XP? Yeah. Probably not a good decision on their part, but hey, who am I to judge? They're rich, you know, and all that, so maybe they're trying to force us to use higher versions of the internet. However, I actually can, with the new update, update using Internet Explorer, so that kind of makes Firefox a bit more obsolete, and I don't really have much of a use for Firefox at this point, other than a couple other sites that I might use that will require Firefox rather than Internet Explorer 8. So, let's see here. But yeah, a few fixes, which I'm actually happy about. Still need to fix the comment system. Like I said, biggest gripe about that change towards the end of last year, which nobody really liked. Nobody wanted to use Google Plus or be forced to make a Google Plus account just to make comments again on YouTube videos. let's see here. Let's hit the fifth floor. I suppose at this point I'm done complaining about Google Plus. Perhaps I'm done with my blogging at this point. I may start cutting out until we get higher up in the tower. I don't keep recording going in case something shows up. But for now, I'm just gonna keep climbing the tower and see if I get new stuff. And I never actually did use this white scene. Any upgrade items? Spine Killer. I still want a Poison Ball. Please, please, please. Do that. But yeah, I suppose probably cut out once I get up to maybe 11th floor or so. Unless I've got something worth showing. Okay, so we've just got an egg. I just picked up an egg. I threw some seeds away just to... because I didn't need them, but I will see if I can find a truth quest sooner or later, because... if I get a truth quest, I can see what this mystery is, but I just picked one up here in this room. For now, though, just back to cutting it off for later on, I suppose. Okay, I actually used a trap loop earlier in this floor, and actually showed a bunch of traps in this room. I don't think I ever actually shown was like this type of trap, so I might as well just do it here. That's all it really is. Reversal trap, flame trap, those can hurt if they hit you the wrong time, and warp trap. So yeah, that's basically all it is. If you've got a trap loop, you can see traps like I was. Oh, nice. Mirror shield worked. That's one of the main reasons why I have this mirror shield, is because those clowns have lowdown. And lowdown will lower your level. So, and about halfway to the next level, and I will have lost all the experience I gained in the last floor or so. Let's see here. I think I'm about ready to cut yet again. Why do they always do that? Kill themselves with their own spell and like, okay, experience. Yay, I got some red sand! It's taking this long for me to get me a sand that increases either my sword or shield. It's been a pretty dry run so far. Aside from, well, a couple of those white sands and items that I got for, I don't know, but, I really want to upgrade my sword and shield, so I at least stand a half decent chance against all these enemies here. I never actually mentioned the name of those things before, but yeah. Let's see here. Things are actually getting pretty hectic. I've had several close shaves up to this point. And I've had to use pretty much every trick in my goodie bag, every goodie in my goodie bag up to this point, to survive, because, well, it's been quite hard to, I would have been finished a lot of times by now, and been for the items that I have. Am I gonna die here? I might have to use some items. You die. Hopefully I got some charges left on my thing. Well, I've been using this thing a lot up to this point. And I survived. I think this is going to be it. I am done here, unfortunately. Could not get up to the 15th floor and get the Guru's oil pot, but unfortunately this is going to be the end of this run here. See how much I get. Just a moment. Get up, pal. Yep. There you go. It's Here's my stuff. Alright, first of all, let's see what's in that egg. It is a noise, weakest wind elemental. However, noise has special ability. I haven't gotten into this before, but certain monsters have traits that can be passed on to others when you fuse them. And haven't really gotten into fusion. That's another episode for another time. But yeah, ooh, shiny fountain. We'll deal with this more later. For now, though, I am going to make a quick trip to Barry's woman shop, and we'll deal with the town on the next episode. But let's see how much money I make. Ooh, cursed gold sword, 4,500 gold. Yeah, I keep gold swords. Cursed hammer, 4,500 gold. Cursed shield. I'm gonna be rolling in it when I'm done here. Binding balls, zero shots. Weak balls are quite weak, actually, as far as balls goes. They're not very helpful for the most part. Let's see here. How much am I gonna get? 19,800. That is quite a good run. I'm actually fortunate to get that much, because I think the next Monster Hut upgrade is going to cost quite a bit more once we've gotten past the first couple upgrades. However, we'll deal with the town in the next episode, and save the game, yes, once again. Do I want a Peter Fruit? Let's see here. Guess I want a Peter Fruit, and I want to put that Mazara Seed into storage. I'll be using Mazara Seeds a lot more in the future. What they do is they level you up, but it's pointless to use on Geico. And as I've explained already, I don't want to be leveling up my familiars at this point. So, I think we'll just save the game here and call it an episode. So, yeah, quite a haul from this run, even though I didn't get all that many sands. I should at least mention before I close things off, I did use one of the charges of my Acerine Ball. However, I suppose I've got a net gain of one because I found two white sands in there, and thankfully I got another red sand for my gold sword. Hopefully I'll get more sands in the future. Once I get to like gold sword plus 10, mirror shield plus 10, I probably won't need to do grinding on the first couple floors, first several floors, because that's how good any weapon gets once they've gotten a good several sands put onto them. But anyways, let's see here. I think I am done. So, going to save the game, and I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.